In the previous video, we created this table. In this case, it's a linked table to an existing SQL Server database. But how do we actually make use of this in the elements? So if I go out here, is there a way, is there some kind of a reference that I can go out and get data from that table? As you can see, there's a table lookup option here. It's a type of a data reference. I can associate that with an attribute. And what I'm doing is basically I'm going to be passing an argument and looking to see if that argument matches the material ID, and then I'll instruct it to return one of these columns. In this case, I'll try to retrieve the heat capacity. So if that's my product, and if I can look this product up and say, okay, if my product matches that material ID, then I'll instruct it to return that heat capacity. And I'll do this over here, and I'll just create this as a new element called heat capacity. So how would I go about doing that? Well, first of all, I have to make sure that this is, and this is just a minor point, but I have to make sure that this is extensible, this particular element. Right now, this element, I cannot add new attributes to it. And if you recall, it's because of what we did in a previous exercise. When we did our exercise a little while ago in creating these templates, if you remember, one of the things I did was I associated this new template with that element, but this template does not allow extensions. So the first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and select Allow Extensions. I'll check that in. And now, if I go back in here and look at this mixing tank, the mixing tank that's based on that template, now I should be able to create new attributes. As you can see now, as opposed to before, now I can actually create new attributes. So this is just kind of a minor point, but since this is based on an element template, I have to make sure that element template will support adding new attributes first. Now, of course, that's got nothing to do with this table lookup. It's just something I needed to do in order to start creating new attributes. So the first attribute I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new attribute that documents in this particular element what the product name is. I'll choose the new attribute and I'll call it product, and this is simply going to be a string. Now this product name, this is what I'm going to try to match to the material ID. So we'll make this a string, and in this case, let's say the current value for this is WX12000. Now that's not just an arbitrary number, or that's not just an arbitrary product name there. I did that because in my library, if we take a look at this table that's in SQL Server, you can see that there is a row in this table in which the material ID is WX12000. So that's actually where I'm going to be making the link between the two. Now I want to retrieve the heat capacity. I want to retrieve the heat capacity when my product is equal to WX12000. So let's go back to the elements. I'm going to add a brand new element here. And this time, this element's going to be a data reference to a table lookup. So let's call this, we're going to call this the heat capacity. And that heat capacity is going to be a data reference to a table lookup. Now, like other data references, this has a settings where we get to set, you know, how we retrieve this. And the first item in that is which of the tables in AF we're going to be retrieving this from. Well, this is going to be that table still in SQL. By the way, let me show you before and after here. The default is that it found the very first table, and it found the three columns that are in that table. If I switch to a different table, we will go out and find whatever columns are in that table. Now what this is, this result column, is what it is we're trying to retrieve. As I said earlier, we wanted the heat capacity, so I'm going to bring the heat capacity in. You know, this is kind of confusing because I've got them named both the same things. They certainly don't need to be named the same thing. So just to make sure there's no ambiguity here, let me just call this my heat capacity. That's going to be the heat capacity in this context within this element right here. So again, I'll go in here. I'm going to specify table still in SQL. I'll go out and look for the results column, which is heat capacity in this case. And I don't want to do any calculations at this point. I'm simply going to bring in the raw data. So let's ignore summary and order, etc. And here's where I'm actually going to make that connection. I said that I wanted to check to see when the product ID is equal to that material ID. But what we're doing is we're showing you the columns here from that table, material ID, and we're going to try to map those to the attributes that already exist in the element I'm currently working with. So one of the attributes, the one I just added, is this attribute called product. We're specifying here when that material ID is equal to product, that's the, you know, when that is a match, then it's that result we're going to be bringing back, that heat capacity we're going to bring back. I'll go ahead and add this. There's our query. Go ahead and say OK. And as you can see, the big finish to this is we actually are now retrieving that heat capacity. If I go back to my library, you can see that was the heat capacity with that product. And just to make it obvious, let's say I had a different product in that particular element, HC15000, for example. If my product were different, let's change that to HC15000, we would retrieve a different set of results. I'm not going to see that until I refresh my screen. Now we resequence this alphabetically. There's HC15000, and my heat capacity is now coming back as 0.87, which is the heat capacity for that product. Okay, let's point out a couple of things over here. First of all, if we go into these to look at this attribute here, this is my heat capacity. Yeah, notice the settings is something that I can use to configure this, but I can also edit this by hand. If you look over here, this is actually the SQL statement that we're executing. So for example, instead of heat capacity, I could have said, let's select the viscosity. And let's take a look at what happens over here. You see, now we're bringing back viscosity instead, or density, or any of these others. There we go, there's density now. And secondly, within settings, if you recall, there were these summary options, and this is just basically going to be generating some SQL code for us. But let me show you how we can make use of that. I would like to retrieve not just the viscosity of a specific row, but let's do an average viscosity. Let's do one of these aggregates or summaries. So what I can do, let me create a new attribute here. I'm going to call this average viscosity. This is going to be a table lookup. I guess I should have done this earlier. Let's just make this a single precision real so that we can use it properly in calculations and whatnot. And for the data reference, we'll do a table lookup. Now, as we did before, when we choose the table lookup settings, you get a choice of the different tables that exist in AF. So far, I only have three. Here's the one that's reaching out and grabbing data from SQL Server. Now, when I switch to that, we see a list of all the columns. Now, this time I'm going to retrieve viscosity, but instead of just the viscosity of whatever I select, I'm going to choose to show the average viscosity, and then I'm going to set up a select statement that's going to actually retrieve many different viscosities. In fact, all of the viscosities. I'll do that like this. I'll say the material ID is like, and then from here I can just put in a an asterisk. Let me go ahead and add that. And when I retrieve this, this material ID like asterisk, it essentially is going to match all the materials in that table. And this, because it's a summary and average, is going to give me the average viscosity for all of those. So when I acknowledge, as you can see, this average viscosity, what it's doing, it's going out to this viscosity column, it's finding everything that matches material ID is equal to asterisk, which is the wildcard character. So it finds all six, and it simply adds up these viscosities and divides by six. Or, for example, instead of saying, let's match to all, I can just say, well, we're only interested in the viscosity of those rows here in which the density is greater than 3,000. So go back here. And I can either do it from within here, just type it in by hand, or I'll just go and do it in here in settings. I'm going to change this over, and let's say when the density is greater than 3,000. And when you add these, is going to be added to this statement. I can go ahead and modify this. I'm only going to restrict it to that one statement. And watch what happens to our SQL query over here. And one last option I want to mention is that if you do have a column that requires some type of interpolation, like strapping table calculations or something like that, in which you have in your SQL database or in your relational database, you've got one column here that represents values you're trying to look up, and then the column over here that represents the values you're trying to return, and you simply want to do an interpolation so that, say, if this comes in at is passed in at 2.2, it comes back as the interpolated value between 20 and 30 that would represent that interpolation between 2.2 and 3, then there is an interpolate operator that you can use. So that's all supported. These are all, you know, SQL constructs. In this example, that's exactly the result you would get. If you put in a 2.2 and you configured it properly, you would get returned a 22.